Speak up. Can you hear me?
Yeah.
There we go. A little bit better?
Yeah.
Mask off. I don't know. I don't want President Stokes to.
Yeah.
No.
6 feet away.
I'm getting a no. I'm not gonna do it. All right. Yeah, President Stokes and myself have a little challenge that we're getting ready to do, and I don't want to upset her. So her and I are going to play a little game of one-on-one basketball in here and video it as a fun way to just, again, engage the community. So if you want to come and maybe watch that go down, I'll let you know when it's happening, all right? So on behalf of the UNM Alumni Association and the Lobo Living Room Committee, I want to welcome everyone here to Johnson Center. We're going to do a tour and listen to our volleyball team talk, our volleyball head coach, Jon Newman-Gonchar. When the women's volleyball team was a powerhouse, top 10, top 15 program, and they used to just absolutely kill it. And I've been a volleyball fan ever since. So I strongly support you ladies and encourage and hope that you have a fantastic season and you'll see me in the stands. So I would also, another challenge, get your tickets for athletic events this year. Our university needs us more than ever. I've been a college basketball season ticket holder for 30 years. I've never bought Lobo football tickets in 30 years. This year I bought Lobo football season tickets. And it's just a little thing that we can do like that to help out our university in this time of need. So there'll be a lot of challenges and encouragements coming from me. That's just kind of the way I roll. You can accept it or not, but you're never gonna know, you're never gonna be able to say that I didn't put out the ask. As an entrepreneur, I am perfectly okay with people telling me no. So I put out the ask always, all right? So we're gonna have a great evening this evening here. We wanted to bring back the pack here to Johnson Center, home of the volleyball and swimming and diving team. And we're thanking everybody for joining us both personally and by way of Zoom. The Lobo Living Room was created in 2012 to shine a spotlight on outstanding UNM programs, faculty, alumni, and community members. Prior to the pandemic and throughout the pandemic, the Lobo Living Room Committee has continued to engage alumni, students, faculty, staff, and the community through our presentations, highlighting alumni, faculty, and community members in their areas of expertise. We'd now like to give away a few prizes. So who wants some prizes? Yeah, we always love prizes. So who's gonna come up and help me with the prizes?
Get out your
tickets, I'm told. Okay. And this is Erica. If I say hi to Erica.
Hi, Erica.
She is in charge of the Lobo Living Room Committee this year. She's going to be doing a lot of work. We're hoping to get our Lobo Living Room. That's going to have to be filled up, but she's ready for it. All right, are we pulling the first one? All right, here we go.
Shook them.
Good. 574903. Hey! It's like Lobo Dash. How many more?
Four.
Four more. Want to call one out?
All right. This one is 574973.
Hey! Call one out. Go for it. Tell everybody who you are.
Hi, I'm Allie Cole. I am from Minnesota. I'm a sophomore on the volleyball team, and I chose UNM because of the engineering program and the program, like volleyball program.
Yeah.
The ticket number is 574921.
Hey. We have two more.
Yeah.
All right, two more. Coach is going to call this one out. Yeah, they can run good. 574892. Hey. Oh, yeah. All right, here we go. Last one is 574994. Hey! Excellent. All right, so just want to send out a reminder to alumni that you can purchase a Johnson recreational card for access to Johnson Center for a reduced monthly fee. All right. Visit the benefits page at unmalumni.com to learn about this alumni benefit and many others. After I graduated from UNM, for about 6-7 years, I had one of those cards that I kept, and that was my gym membership for many, many years. And then I just kind of let it go. And I think they put it away for a while, and now they brought it back. So another great way to support our university here. I'd now like to welcome Jon Newman-Gonchar.
Yay! Yeah.
He was hired on January 21st, 2019, becoming UNM's 10th head volleyball coach. Prior to coaching at UNM, Newman-Gonchar served as the associate head coach at the University of Arkansas for 3 seasons. Prior to Arkansas, he was an assistant coach at Iowa State and Ames. This summer, he served as an assistant coach for the U.S. women's under 20 national volleyball team that finished 5th at the World Championships just a few weeks ago. Yeah. All the way over here in section N. Can you hear me okay? So my volume is okay. How about over here? All the way in K. L. Thank you. First of all, I just, let's give it up for these guys for putting on this event. It's a tough year to put stuff on. A really challenging year to put stuff on. And so for Johnson Center for opening its doors and for these guys making this event possible, I'm fired up to be here. I believe, if I'm not mistaken, it's the first time UNM Volleyball has been a guest of the Lobo Living Room. Is that correct? Yeah. Give it up for these guys. So the chance to get in front of you guys, we jumped at it. We said, absolutely. We'll clear the calendar to make sure we can do it. And turns out this is these guys' days off to come out here. And this is their one day off this week to come out here and spend the night with you guys for a few minutes. Yeah. I feel closer. Like I'm kind of like a vibe guy. I need to feel the vibe. What I want to say is that we're excited to start our season. And I'm excited for a number of reasons. One, we've got a crew this year that has experience. There's some players up here that have 6 years of Division I volleyball experience. There's players up here that represent their national teams in Israel or in Mexico. And it's an exciting time of year. The fall is an exciting time of year with football starting and volleyball starting. And we need you guys. We need you guys. We represent you guys. I know we didn't quite have the hand raise of all the people that are members of the association, but we represent all of you guys. And we want to see these guys become you guys. Does that make sense? You know what I'm saying? Yeah. We want these guys to be you guys. That's a big deal. We need them to graduate. And we need them to go out into the community and represent this shield. And we do it every day on the court. We represent you guys every day on the court. One of our team goals is to win the classroom. These guys just finished their 4th semester in a row with a 3.6 GPA or higher. Our second goal is to win the Mountain West Conference, is to win this conference. It is a lofty goal. Thank you. It is a lofty goal. We have not done it yet. We are trying to make history. We are trying to do something that has never been done before at this university. Again, we represent you guys.
Yeah.
Our last goal, so we have three. Our last goal is we win the community, that you guys know who these people are and they know who you are. It's really important if you're a UNM athlete that you're represented in this community and you represent this community. It goes both ways, in my opinion. And so we do everything and anything we can to get out in front of you guys and to represent you again. Again, let's give it up to these guys. Just take a second. I want them to introduce themselves. And I want them to tell you guys why they're so fired up, not only to represent you on the volleyball court, but to, in the future, represent you as alumni. Let's start right here. Kate, come on up.
Hi, everyone.
Hi.
My name is Caitlin Biasu. I'm a junior. I'm from the great state of Nevada. I'm a business liberal arts major. I just switched. But I chose UNM because I love the program. I love the mountains. I love the view. I love almost everything about Albuquerque. the second I came here, I knew this is the place I wanted to be. So I'm very happy to be here and standing in front of you guys. So thank you.
Hi, my name is Michelle Gareca. I'm from Guadalajara, Mexico. I'm a junior, and I chose UNM because I love this community and the support you give us.
Hi, I'm Callie Wolf. I'm from Minnesota. I'm a sophomore, and I chose UNM for the engineering program as well as like the awesome coaches that we have.
Hi, my name is Chloe Clark. I'm a junior from Houston, Texas, and I chose UNM because of the great education that I could get here, as well as getting to know all of you guys in the community.
I'm from Israel, and I chose UNM because I love the volleyball program and the people, and just like the vibes are really good here, and I love everything about here.
Hi, my name is Melissa Walden. I'm from Aurora, Illinois. I'm a sophomore English major, and I chose UNM because of the people I'm able to surround myself with here.
I'm Cassie McGill. I'm from California, and I'm in grad school for business. And I chose UNM because I love the support the community gives the athletic program.
Hi, my name is Aaliyah Rasmussen. I'm a junior from Highland, Utah. My major is psychology, and I chose UNM because I wanted to be part of a program that pushes us to excel in every aspect of life.
I'm a graduate student. I'm in the Anderson School of Business MBA program, and I chose UNM because the program is really nationally ranked and just everything that I could accomplish here.
My name is Elena. I'm from Minnesota. I'm a junior this year, and I chose UNM because of the academics, the volleyball, and all the support we get from you guys. So we appreciate you all.
Member of my coaching staff here, please.
Hi, my name's April Sanchez. I'm one of the assistant coaches here, and I chose UNM because after a few phone calls with John, I wanted to be part of something special and go for something really hard. So.
Well, you've gotten to know us a little bit. Now I want to get to know you guys.
Zachary. Welcome back, Zachary.
All right. So tell me, how many of you guys have been to a volleyball match? Okay. All right. That's 8. That's pretty good. How many of you guys are coming back to a volleyball match? Whoa, now we go. There we go. Supporting these guys. My next one was, how many volleyball players do we have in here? I know we got a couple right there. Hey, all right. All right. I want to take a second, so you got to kind of know some faces and some names. And now I want to talk to you about the quality of people that we're bringing into this program and why I think it's so special. And you've heard them all say why they think it's special. When we go out recruiting, and it's a year-long task, we do this 365 days a year. Yeah, no kidding. Every day of the year, I have some type of recruiting involvement going on because we're trying to bring in the very best people we can to this program. The challenge we come up with is you can go into a gym anywhere across the country and I can tell you who the tallest player is. We can all figure that out. I can tell you that you can tell me who the tallest, highest jumping player is, who the hardest hitting player is. And there's a lot of those. But for me, with this program, we wanted to find really specific types of people that would accelerate that process of where we're trying to go and where we are currently. And we thought there were 4 factors. And so I just want to mention that because these guys are going to represent you guys someday. You guys represent us. The very first one is our core value. Number one is this idea of humility, that we don't think of ourselves, less of ourselves. We just think of ourselves less often. We're going to put other people in front of us. You know what I'm saying? We are humble people. And you will know that about these guys the more you get to know them. The second piece of that is this idea of hunger, that we want to chase something and achieve something that has never been done before. So we have to be absolutely hungry and accept the fact that none of us are good enough yet. I'm not good enough yet. Our crew's not good enough yet. We are not there yet. So we are humble enough to accept that, but we are hungry enough to change that, to impact that. And that's what we're doing every day. You guys can see we've got three whiteboards down there. We've got four volleyball nets up. They're in here every morning working their tails off. Then we give them a couple hours to refuel. You like that part? Especially when it's Chipotle day like today.
Yeah. Okay.
And then they come back and they put another 2.5 hours of work in. They represent you guys. You guys represent them. The third piece for us is gratitude. Humble, hungry, grateful people. We ask for them to understand that an attitude of gratitude is what's going to make us great Lobos for life. We are grateful to represent this university. We're grateful to wear this shield on our chest. And it's an everyday deal. It's not just, hey, on the days I feel good. It's an everyday deal. We're grateful for those opportunities. The last piece is kindness. These are an incredibly kind group of people. Don't get me wrong. You don't want to be on the other end of a Cassie spike. you just don't want to. She's an All-Mountain West Conference player. Kate Biasu is an All-Mountain West Conference player. You don't want to be on the other end of it. Trust me. If you stand a little too close to the sideline and hit one out, you fear for your life. So we've got these four core values. So when I go out recruiting, everyone says, well, how do you figure it out? How do you make a team? How do you figure out your roster? For us, it's very simple. We invest deeply in these people to not find out, are they going to represent you, our alumni, as well as they possibly can? It's because you represent them and they represent you. And I think that's just such a massive deal, you guys. So, yeah. All right. Three things you're going to see this year from these guys. Is we have depth and we have experience. And that makes that scary. When you've got depth and you've got experience, that's pretty scary. They are going to be tenacious defenders. You should see them running through walls, literally, to go get volleyballs up. And then they are going to be aggressive offensive terminators. They are going to be aggressive offensive terminators. When you come to watch this team play, you're going to see this depth at every single position. You're going to see incredible defensive plays. And you're going to see really inspiring offensive performances. It's going to be awesome, you guys. We want to see you guys. Yeah. Let's give it up. We want to see you guys at our exhibition match. It's going to be held at the Pit. I believe it's the 21st. So not this Saturday, but following Saturday at 1 p.m. We're hosting a kids clinic after. Bring your kids, bring your nieces, your nephews. Bring them all. You can participate too if you'd like. Yeah, we're wide open. Yeah, we don't have an age restriction. Just bring your mask, bring your tennis shoes, and we'll play a little volleyball. Then we start our very first home weekend after the exhibition. We host Seattle University, UC San Diego, and Southeastern Louisiana State. So we've got a solid tournament coming here. And then we start Mountain West Conference 2 weeks later. We'd love to see you guys when we get back into Johnson Center and we start conference play. Yeah. Right off time. I'm a time guy. It's 7:01. As we wrap up, I want to do a little bit of trivia. Can we do some trivia, you guys?
Woo!
Make it kind of fun.
Woo!
Start up through a little bit. Okay. The very first trivia question. Come on up. We're gonna go millionaire style, but trust me, it gets really tricky. So if you don't want to like vote in, if you don't want to chime in, you may miss your chance because it's gonna get really hard really fast. The first question up is gonna come from Kate, and this is for a Lobo water bottle, everybody. All right, Kate, step on up.
All right, is everyone ready?
Yep.
What?
Yeah.
Okay. How many players are on each side of the court? Six.
Six.
Yeah.
I told you it starts off with a $100 round. Don't worry, it's getting up there. Machi.
All right. Question two. What is an ace and what is a kill?
What is an ace and what is a kill?
Woo!
Question number three. Question number three.
What conference does UNM play in?
Question four.
What is a libero and what skills must they master?
You got to get all of them. Okay, right here.
Close. What skills must they master?
So to answer, to kind of build off that, the libero is going to wear a different colored what?
Jersey.
And so she can come in and out for a back row player only. So you were very close, but it's just specific to just a back row player. So your skills are going to be passing, digging, and serving at the NCAA level. Yeah, good. I like the answer. Here we go. Question four, is it?
Five.
It's getting up there, you guys.
All right, this is a tough one. So who did Team USA play for in the finals at the Olympics, and who won?
Brazil. And they beat them in three sets.
Yeah.
All right. We're going fastest hands in the Southwest, the land of enchantment for this one. I like it, Brian. You're ready. The Cobra. Okay. Here it is. It's going to be Chloe Clark.
Who will win the Mountain West 2021 volleyball tournament?
All right, you guys, thank you for letting us come hang out in the Lobo Living Room.
We want to thank Coach and the team for showing up this evening. And as a thank you from the UNM Alumni Association, we have a gift for you, folks. Yeah. So there, the team is leaving. Everybody say goodnight. Time to practice in the morning.
7 a.m.
practice.
See you guys. Thank you.
I have a favor to ask. So I started a tourism-based business back in 2009 because I loved Albuquerque and somebody needed to show it off and nobody was doing it. So my buddy Jesse and I, who's also an alum, we started a tourism-based business. And so for the last 12 plus years, we get people from all over the world to take our tour. And every single tour comes through the campus. And as we pass by Johnson Gym, every single tour for the last 12, 13 years does the Everyone's a Lobo. Woof, woof, woof. So let's do that real quick. Loud enough to where the team can hear us as they exit the building. All right. So I'll say Everyone's a Lobo. You say woof, woof, woof. And then on the trolley, we added a howl at the end of the last woof. Everyone's a Lobo. Woof, woof, woof. Give it up. Right. Here we go. Everyone's a Lobo.
Woof, woof, woof.
There it is. Awesome. Add the howl at the end. A lot more fun. All right, so our next guest is going to be a guy that when I was an undergrad at UNM and I worked, my work study job was leisure services. So I was in Johnson Gym refereeing intramurals, college intramural basketball and intramural football and intramural softball, whatever they had going on, I reffed and made a few bucks to help me get through college. And back then, JT was working in the building, and today JT runs the building, all right? So let's give it up for Jim Todd. Talk to us a little bit about Johnson Center and the innovation.
Bad time to choke on your water, right? Well, thank you for being here tonight. This is the first opportunity we've had to showcase this brand new facility, and you'll be able to contrast it with old and new, and hopefully we can make some renovations to the old. So the entire center is, you know, up to par with everybody else. So I knew I would have trouble projecting because any volleyball coach or any college coach, they're not going to have any problems with that, right? They're going to be used to that with their athletes. So, and thank you, Mike, for his opportunity. I will say that Mike was a little liberal with his assessment of his basketball skills. Totally, I agree. So, but no, I do remember Mike when he was a student employee working with us, and never a complaint about what he did. And he was also, you know, really a great sportsman on the basketball court as well. And so I'm not surprised that he's in this position because he led Lobo Red at the time. And obviously he still does. So my department, Recreational Services, is part of a bigger family on campus that's called Student Affairs. Student Affairs is charged with providing support services for students that help them be successful, make good grades, stay engaged, stay in school. And we're lucky tonight to have the Vice President of Student Affairs to say a few words about the division, and then we'll get back into this specific program, this specific building. So Dr. Tim Gutierrez, he also started in this building, believe it or not. So we're kind of migrating throughout campus, spreading our word with Dr. Tim Gutierrez.
Short, sweet, but I do have to comment on Mike's memory of his basketball. I don't remember it like that either. I've been here a long time. At this day, I hired him as an employee here at Johnson Center. So there's a long history here. So I'm very proud to be here to represent the student affairs. Student affairs is focused on students. And we do whatever you can provide services. Advising and just financial scholarships. I know one of the things that I want to emphasize is we're going to be looking at a mentoring program that I hear mentioned. What a better place to come the students are the ones who pay for this facility. Bottom here, enjoy the facility with them, and this is just a perfect spot to. I also want to compliment Jim and his staff, not longer managing. So tonight you're going to walk through it. There's a lot of spaces. Something that we have been looking for years. As many of you know, this started off with over the years it grew, and Recreational Services was called the Intramural Sports Only. Now, one of the primary goals of this facility is to provide services for students. We've also, as you know, as you saw, home. It's still here. This is one of the few multi-use facilities. So I hope I want to thank everyone for being as JP alluded to, this is kind of an unofficial open house, our first one. And I hope you guys really enjoy it. And again, I want to thank the Alumni Association for bringing it here and giving us the opportunity. Thank you.
So it's my turn to quiz you all. I have a question. Does anybody know when this building first opened? I was told 1957. If you were here, you probably know. 1956, I will change my memory with that. So, and like Tim alluded to, it was built primarily to house the Lobo basketball team. and they threw in physical education as a sidebar in order to get funding. You know, it's an academic building as well, not just an athletic facility. So it's always served a dual purpose. It's always been educational and athletic. A couple years after that, recreation came along, and it was housed under athletics as well, but they started opening up the building for students to come in and play basketball and lift weights and all of that. So over the years, as Tim mentioned, it's been expanded. They built on each four sides and expanded, adding the pool a little bit later after that. So what you'll see is back final renovation or addition. But we hope there's a couple other that include renew of the aquatic program and bringing this old lady right here into the modern ages. So we are a typical recreation program, very popular with students, faculty, and staff. We have programs such as intramural sports, club sports, aquatics, fitness, very popular program. We have an outdoor adventure center, which houses equipment rental and a full-service bicycle shop. So we provide all the amenities, all the teachers and students who are living on campus and then want to come back to campus to need for their recreational needs, right? They have downtime. Students have downtime between studying. We want them to rejuvenate, refresh, help our building for healthy recreational opportunities. So you'll be dividing up into groups. A lot of my staff is here, along with some of our student staff, and they'll take you throughout the building to the new parts, ask you questions. I think you'll be very impressed with what you see. As Tim mentioned, this was entirely funded by student fees. There's no capital money put in. 100% student fees. The total cost of the project was $35 million. After everybody took their little piece of the pie, we had $28 million left to build it. So there were quite a few features that were left off. We were hoping to put a climbing wall in. We were hoping for it to be a little bit bigger, for it to have a little more equipment into it. But I think what we finally ended up building for $28 million is amazing. I think you'll agree with me once you've seen it. I know you kind of got to preview it as you walk through, but hopefully you get a better in-depth picture of everything. They'll take you in all the spin studios and the dance studios and the weight training rooms and the track and all of that. So I think that covers me, Mike.
Yep.
What do we have left?
All right, so let's give it up for JT, everyone. We're going to break off and go do the tours now for those that are interested. But JT, before you take off, as a thank you from the UNM Alumni Association, we have a gift for you. There you go. Thank you to JT and his team for putting this on for us, allowing us in the building and having an opportunity to now go and take a walk through the building and get a real up close and personal look at Johnson Gym. So what we're going to do, so we're going to head down to the court here. Once we get down to the court, JT staff is going to split us into smaller groups, and then we're going to go ahead and take a tour. And once the tour is complete, this evening will be over. So before we leave, I want to remind you to please head over to the UNM alumni website. And if you have not joined the Albuquerque chapter, please do so. We are eager. I am eager to cultivate a group of mentors in this community that are willing to put some time together and be of service to those here at our university, because from this university become our future leaders. And, you know, when I was at UNM, I didn't quite see that mentoring opportunity. And I want to change that for some folks. When I was an undergrad at the University of New Mexico, I never stepped foot inside Hodgson Hall, never. How many of you ever stepped foot inside Hodgson Hall when you were an undergrad? Again, not a whole lot of hands. How many of you have been to Hodgson Hall now? Much better. So let's try to flip that so that as our undergrads are matriculating through the university here, we're gonna do some things to get them over to our building so we can introduce them to the UNM Alumni Association and build relationships now instead of when they're done and they get a letter saying, hey, thanks for going to UNM. Can you scratch us a check, right? So we want to try to build some relationships. So head on down to the floor here and we'll have our tour. And thanks again, everybody, for coming.
Contract. Are there royalties involved with this? Yeah. Are we good to go? All right. Well, thank you for being here. So the purpose of the tour is just to kind of walk you around, let you see the new facility, the new features, the new amenities that it has. And if any time you have any questions about it, please let me know. Otherwise, I can just talk all night about the center. I'm not good in a formal setting, but when you get me just walking around freewheeling, I get to be pretty good, pretty animated. I mean, this is my life. This is what I do. You know, I flunked out of math. So what was left for me, right? You know, chemistry, no. Math, no. You know, it took me 4 attempts at calculus, and I never got through. So it was recreation, and I love it. I don't regret it. I don't look back. So I'm thrilled to be here and to show you my facility. So does anybody have any questions to start off with? We just want to get right in and go for it, right?
Sounds good.
Yeah. Okay, so we'll probably be playing bumper cars with a lot of the other new groups because there's really not a whole lot of space to navigate. But like I discovered tonight, the building opened in 1956. I thought it was 57, but I'll change my recollection of that. And it was a typical building at the time. You know, it was a John Galmeen building. Any architect buffs in here? He was the university architect at the time. He also designed a lot of the other buildings on campus, some of the residence halls, and his architectural style is really prevalent in the building. You would think that we covered it all up, but we were able to save a little bit of the old and merge that with the new, and I think they did a really good job with that. But a lot of the effort into the project by the architects and the designers was to open it up. Everything was attached by a small, narrow hallway. And if you've been in the building before, you kind of had to go left, go right, go left, go right, leave a trail of breadcrumbs to find your way out. And nobody knew where anything was. You know, where's this? Where's that? So a lot of effort was put into making pedestrian thoroughfares, walkways, pathways. And I think they were reasonably successful in doing that. Now, there were parts of the old building that you couldn't change structurally because the building would collapse. So there's still a narrow hallway, but I think we've addressed this as well as we could a lot of that. So they added about 60,000 square feet new and renovated about 60,000 square feet old. And like I mentioned earlier, the project was $35 million total budget. We had $28 million left to build it. I think we did an outstanding job. So if we want to follow me, duck under the net, that's great. Otherwise, you can walk around over there.
Can you hold the door?
We're going to run straight into that group, so we're going to take a look at this. So we're just taking a little detour. This isn't anything new. This is everything old, but it definitely contrasts with the new section. But an interesting fact about this is one of our more popular features in the building is our weight room. And we were going to be closed for 18 months. And they completely gutted the old weight room. We wanted to keep the weight room. And so what we did is we converted this into a temporary weight room. We went and covered the floor with polyvinyl tarp, parking. And then we put three quarter inch plywood on top of that, and then a rubber floor on top of that. And then we relocated the weight room into here. So it worked out well. It was actually very well received. It was much bigger than the old weight rooms. And so people weren't lifting on top of each other. So it actually worked out quite well, but we're glad to have this gym back. This is where I like to play basketball. If you notice, the courts are rather short. So, and for those of us that don't play defense, we just like to chuck the three. We have about 20 feet to walk in between to take our shots. And so this is a, believe it or not, this is a really popular gym, and mainly among the older faculty and staff. But anyway, we're just walking through here to avoid everybody that's walking that way. So we're just going to gather here, talk here, and then we'll head down the hallway. So back in 1956, we had four racquetball courts, and we're standing in one of them right now. Over the years, those racquetball courts were cannibalized, turned into a weight room, and then the weight room was cannibalized, and it was turned into aerobic room. So, and then when there was the 1984 edition had eight racquetball courts, but then those all went away. So there's been a lot of moving parts in this building. Someone coming down the hallway? Okay, good. We're gonna go quick. Okay. So anyway, when we go in that hallway, the first room you see, it's just a multi-purpose aerobic room. The second room you see is our indoor cycling room. Some people call it spin. We can't because that's trademarked. They have the spin police to come out and find you if you use the word spin. So we're indoor cycling or global cycling, as we want to start calling it. And then the next room you see, the last room you'll see, is another multi-purpose room. We call it the dance room. We're really creative in how we name things. The dance room, the aerobic room. So, you know, a lot of places you go to the Hamas room or the Jewel room or the Mountain View room. We're just really practical here. It makes it easy. When you see the last room, you see the dance room. It was the original weight room in the building. It literally looked like a prison. It had a chain link fence in the middle of it, free weights on one side, a 1920 universal machine on the other side, no cardio, and it stunk. So we've moved far away from that. So spend a few minutes in each room if you want to, but then we'll meet down at the very end. Go ahead.
This is a multi-purpose room. Pretty big. This is a cycle room. It's pretty exciting. Very lovely lighting. I wish I had this when I was a student.
That's really cool. Yeah. It's a
my favorite. But it's nice to have that. Thank you. This is a multi-purpose dance room. kind of difficult to show it all. Sorry, thank you.
Your classmates, and they'll superimpose your picture up on the screen, and so you know you can see you're cycling there, or the instructor can monitor your work and your output on the bike and just, you know, get on you, right? Like what's the emu commercial, like, come on bird legs, get spinning. The Liberty Mutual commercial. I'm just full of useless trivia. So but anyway, it's every one of our new multi-purpose rooms is super high tech, right? So we can have video on demand. So let's say our yoga instructor calls in sick or hungover or something like that. You know, we can pull up a yoga class on demand, so we don't necessarily have to cancel class. We can still provide a service. And so we really went all out, full strength, full speed ahead in the stuff that we had. We had a $1.3 million equipment budget, and we spent $1.3 plus a little bit just to make sure that everything we put in the building was brand new. So this project, 18 months to construct, a little bit longer due to COVID, but it started back in 2016 with the design process, and then we started building it. It actually completed in February, last March, 2020. And so we've been sitting barely open for over a year, which is kind of sad. We don't really know how it's going to react when we have everybody in here. We hope that it does well. We think that it should be. We're confident in the design, but it didn't just start in 2016. This process started 10, 15 years before that. We would take student government on trips to other universities and show them what they had. And then they'd come back and see what we had and they go, oh man, ours really kind of sucks. And so, you know, they would work tirelessly behind the scenes to make this happen. We were able to put together three really solid proposals, this being the third one. The second proposal got all the way to the Board of Regents and it was shut down. The first one kind of didn't make it that far, but it's been a process in the making, and it's all been about student government taking this and running with it and literally demanding that the administration do something to upgrade their facilities. So I couldn't go to the Regents and say, I would like a new center. What are you talking about? Students go and they have a voice. President listens to the students, the Regents listen to the students, and they have a voice. So that's why they're all here. We're here. So. So this is the original facade to the building. They did some work on it to clean it up and make it a little bit nicer. But I can remember when I was going to school here, there was a road, literally a road right here after the sidewalk. And I would park my 1969 Datsun 510 right here. So I got to work early enough and you could just go in. So I think they did a great job maintaining a lot of the old features and marrying that with the new. Like I said, this used to be outside. So they built this building in 19, they built what we call a South Gym. That was an addition that started in 1984 and finished in 1987. But it was just connected to this building by a hallway. And this was all open. And so when we did the renovation, we eliminated that hallway, put a nice roof on, put a nice indoor track on, tore out literally four of the walls and filled them in with glass, and they built the indoor track. So it really opened up the building. So we think this is a great area for kids or students or faculty staff to come and meet, socialize. We also created this little cutout area here. I wouldn't say it's for necessarily watching activity that's going on in there, which you absolutely can, but
it's more of a place to gather. Say you're playing intramurals or you're waiting for the next basketball game or the next volleyball game or the next badminton game, and then you kind of hang out here. One really cool feature is that wherever we've created and designed for space for students to gather, any electrical plug has the USB outlets, so you can just plug in, bring your cable and plug in. So I think that's a really cool little feature. So this used to be a 4-court basketball gym, and now it's 3 courts. We didn't lose any programming capability by going to 3 courts, but it definitely opened up the gym. Before, the 4 courts were just right on top of each other. With one curtain, you could divide the facility into 2. Now we can divide it into 3 spaces, just giving us more flexibility. So it just worked. So like I said, this is a John Gao meme building. You can tell by the architecture. He does these high porticos with the nice little design features into it there. I'm not giving any questions. I must be doing great.
The answer, okay, right above it, and we'll see that when we get upstairs. When UNM had a men's wrestling team, that's where they trained, and their mats were red. We've always kept the red because, you know, we're Lobos and we have cherry and red. And so what you're seeing is just the light reflecting off the red mat, and it makes the room glow pink. So what Debbie Morris and Ryan are standing in front of right now, that's going to be our Hall of Honor. There's a touchscreen monitor that will be placed back up here once we get the graphics up. And what the Hall of Honor does is it recognizes individuals that positively influence student life. Not necessarily by an athletic scholarship or a coach. It could be a professor, it could be a mentor, it could be a counselor, it could be an advisor, it could be a teammate, but anybody that has positively influenced a student's life, contributed to their success at UNM, they will be honored and recognized here. And so, like I said, that's a touchscreen. You'll be able to scroll through by name, by picture, by year, by class, by category, touch that, and then you'll get a bio of that individual. So we think that's a really cool future. We're just waiting for the graphics to be installed. So next on our tour is the Outdoor Adventure Center. This is Mr. Charles. Last name, quick.
Quinn.
Charles Quinn.
Stuff your boss said
that. That's what happens when you're 62 years old and you forget people's names. So Charles was also a student employee. Seems like we have a lot of student employees that work for us and then leave and come back, or actually sometimes never leave, like me. I think that's just where New Mexico, there's the land of enchantment, right? There is an enchantment about it. People just are always drawn back. But the Outdoor Adventure Center isn't new, but in the form it is now, it's drastically changed. We used to have the outdoor shop. We used to have the bike shop. We used to have getaway adventures. We used to have the challenge course program. And they were all separate. And so the stars aligned, the planets aligned, and we were able to bring all of those under one roof, to share staff, to share resources, to share equipment. And it was just a win-win-win-win for everybody. And Charles has done an amazing job putting that all together. And I hope you spend a little bit of time walking through there and you can ask Charles any questions that you have to ask.
Here, guys.
Oh, wow. All right.
All right. Well, first and foremost, guys, thank you all for coming tonight. I don't get a chance to show off a lot of my program, mostly because people just don't know, you know. So I'm glad that you guys are here. Hopefully, you'll be able to spread that information. Real quick, do we have any faculty staff in the group? Cool. Any emeritus, so retired folks? Wonderful. So those folks, when we talk about our things, most of the stuff that we do, tuition remission applies. So cool. So as JT mentioned, or Jim Todd mentioned, the Outdoor Adventure Center is an umbrella.
See, he was making fun of me using my last name.
like you mentioned, it used to be three to four to five separate program areas, and now it is under one roof. So on this side, we have our local bike shop. And our outdoor resource and rental centers on that side. Outdoor resource and rental center is a great, great option for students, staff, and faculty to come and get really great equipment at a really discounted price. In addition, we also do trip planning for folks. So if you want to come in and you don't necessarily know exactly what you want to do, but you have a location picked, we can do most of the legwork for you to get campsite reservations, trails and stuff like that to do, get all your equipment together. And most of those services are free other than renting the equipment. So, and we love doing stuff like that. The classes and clinics program, which is fairly new since I got here in 2019. But if you're looking to pick up a hard skill for any outdoor sport that you may think of, we probably offer a class or a clinic for that throughout the semester. If you're looking to say, like, for example, for this fall, we have snowboarding ski tuning. So if you want to learn how to do that on your own, it's a very simple, easy process, but you can come and have professional folks who have done it for a very long time show you how to do it. Same thing, I run a bunch of bike clinics and things like that. So if you're looking to pick up skills about how to work on your own bikes, we do that. And the list kind of goes on. I won't bore you with all of that stuff. We also run the Getaway Adventures program out of here. So if you're looking to do any of the trips, take a look at our schedule. We have a wide variety of things. I usually try to hit six or seven different activities for the fall. Yeah. Think of anything else. Feels
good. Is that an outdoor access?
Yeah, it's nice. So for the shop, things that I love, the bay door. That thing is fantastic. I can't quite squeeze a van in there, but my truck gets in there. Anyway, but yeah, here guys, come on down. So the Lobo Bike Shop, we are a full service bike shop. So anything that anybody that say a bike coupe or two-wheel drive or even the Trek Superstore is doing, we can do that here in-house. So if you do have student, staff, or faculty that you have in your own personal community, send them our way. Our turnaround times are so much faster. What's nice is that the shop is only open 10 to 3, but when it shuts down, it gets real quiet, and then I have a chance to work on whatever's left. I've been a professional mechanic for over 15 years now, 20 years. Anyway, but it's always been one of my passions, no matter what kind of work I was doing. I always had a side job as a bike mechanic or bartender. Yeah, do you guys have any questions or anything about our...
I don't have a question, but I have a comment. I want you all to go ooh and ah. This is my bike here. We're building it from scrap. I'm building myself a cruiser. And so we're trying to put it together with used parts and things. So
yeah, it looks real used. It's nice. So yeah, we do custom builds for folks. I build my own bikes out of the shop. It's one of the benefits. So if you have folks that are going to be students or that are students, if they're ever looking for work, usually every semester I have a little bit of turnover, and that's one of the great benefits for folks is they get to play with all the gear for free. They get to build their own bikes. They get all the discounts that I get, you know what I mean? So I try to keep that a high retention rate for my student staff by trying to offer them as much as I can in the way benefits.
Cool. All right. Well, we might be the last tour to leave the building, but that's your fault.
You chose me.
So this is just one final view of the old entrance to Johnson. We kept it within the building, which is pretty sweet. And this is the new entrance with a whole new weight room. Well, thank you guys for coming and for bearing with us through this hybrid mode. We're going to go ahead and end the tour. Thank you.